guys, it's Robin. Welcome back to my channel. Today I am back with another build, speed build, apartment build. I'm not really sure what to call it, but this is a collab, so I can at least call it that. But yeah, this is a collab with four other simmers. It is a collab with, I'm saying collab a lot, I'm sorry, but it's a collab with Zibinstead, NellyXO, Simplicity, and Marl Sims. But we decided to build like an apartment complex that doesn't necessarily require city living. There might be some elements added in from city living, but you know, for the most part, it's meant to be like a lot with an apartment built onto it. But there are five different apartments because there were five of us working on it, and I believe Marl Sims is the one who built the exterior of the apartment, and then she built five little sections for each of us to build in. And I believe Nelly built two of the apartments. It's the one in the middle upstairs and then one of the other ones. I'm not sure which one, but yeah, I had to look around because I was the last one to build, well, before the fifth apartment got built. But so I haven't seen that one yet, but I've seen the other three apartments. Yeah, the other three apartments, I've seen them and they all look amazing. And yeah, so yeah, yeah, go have a look at their stuff. I'll have all the links and stuff in the description for you guys. But yeah, go have a look at their renovations, build, apartment, decorating. Yes. I'm sorry. But yeah, go have a look at theirs because, yeah, mine's not as great. But, you know, I tried. I don't really build in Oasis Springs, and this is what the apartment was built for. So it's kind of got like a jungly vibe, Oasis Spring, like deserty feel to it. Tropical, I guess, maybe. I don't know. It could be either an Oasis Springs or Silverdorada. Is that the name of it? I don't know. It could go pretty nicely in either one of those worlds. So I try to use some items from Silverdorada and what is it called? Jungle Adventure, maybe? I don't know. But I try to use items from that and some items that I thought would fit in with like Oasis Springs, you know? Kind of tropical Arizona-y, if that makes sense. But yeah, so I don't really build in that style too often, so it was a little bit difficult, but you know, I gave it my best shot and I think it turned out quite nicely. It looks nice, I guess, compared to the other ones. It's not that great, but you know, I tried. And I did want to use some kind of lighter colors, so that's why I'm using lighter colors in the kitchen. I don't know, I just like building in lighter colors anyway, but you know, it probably would have made sense to use darker wood colors. I might change the wood colors, I really can't remember because it's been a while since I built it. But yeah, I'll have a link to the finished lot in the description, and I'll try to get links together for each of the individual apartments for you guys to download those as well. But I'll have links for everybody's stuff in the description, their YouTube channels, Twitters, whatever. I have all that in the description for you guys, so be sure to check out everyone and, you know, their build. Contribution, that's the word. Yes. And then, I can't remember exactly the family or whatever I had in mind for this apartment. I do know that it was roommates. I've been doing a lot of roommate-like apartments lately. I think I've done three this past week, including this one. So, yeah, I've been doing that quite a lot. But, yeah, the rooms were pretty small. I ended up building in a pretty small section of the apartment. I believe two of the apartments are two stories, and then the two in the front are just, like, one story, I guess. And this one and the other one in the front is pretty small, and then the one upstairs is pretty small. And this one, since it was pretty small, the rooms weren't really big enough for me to be able to put a full-size bed in it. So I was gonna do, like, you know, parents and a kid, but I realized that I probably wouldn't be able to fit a full-size bed in either of the rooms because I did want it to have two bedrooms. So yeah, the idea I had for that was just to make it roommates and I could just put a single bed in them, you know, whatever. And I didn't really make them gender specific, I don't believe. So pretty much anyone could live in the rooms. And then I did add some little pets stuff. I believe I added some stuff for dogs. Yeah, I'm pretty sure, because there's like a little bag of food with a dog on it. So I'm pretty sure I had in mind they had a dog. And then that rug, I love that rug. It makes me so happy. It goes with all the builds I love, and it makes me so happy. But anyway, I didn't really have much room. Sorry, I keep blowing into the microphone, by the way. But yeah, I didn't really have too much space to work with for a dining room table. And I did want to have more than two chairs, you know, in case the other tenants in this apartment decided to come over for a visit or whatever. Because, you know, they can do that. Why not? But yeah, I didn't have much room to work with. So yeah, I just put three. I can count. I put three little chairs with the table behind the sofa, which is usually kind of my go-to whenever I have a pretty small space to work with. I usually just put the dining room table like right behind the sofa, like pushed right up against it. You know, it looks nice. It saves a little bit of space. Unfortunately, you can only fit three chairs in it that way, but it's fine. It works. I keep saying I'm really sorry about that, by the way. But what was I saying? Oh yeah, it works out. You know, maybe one of them could eventually have a child that lives in this apartment. I don't know where they would sleep, you know, maybe on the couch. But I just put three chairs in there. They really only need two, but you know, in case they have visitors, friends, whatever, boyfriends, girlfriends, I don't know. But yeah, that's just what I had in mind anyway. And then I think for the column in the kitchen, I just copied one of the columns that was outside, just to kind of give it a little bit of continuity. And then I didn't realize when I was building that the little dog bowl and the bag of dog food was actually stuck inside of a column. So I'm pretty sure the dog could still probably use it. I didn't actually test it, but I'm pretty sure they'd still be able to. Hopefully they'd still be able to. But yeah, it shouldn't be too much of a problem. And if it is, you could just use the move object sheet and move it out just a little bit, just a tad. But yeah, I believe the color palettes for this room is the green colors, and then the other one is like a blue and yellow theme pretty much. And then I put a computer in one of the rooms. I don't know why, but whenever I build like apartment rooms, roommate apartments or houses or whatever, I always just put a computer in one of the rooms and never in the others, and I don't understand why, but it's just something that always kind of happens. But I did try to stick to a specific color palette for each of them. And then I guess this was probably female room, since there's makeup and stuff everywhere. Or just a very high maintenance man, you know, whatever. So, oh yeah, I forgot I did this. I made like a little vanity mirror type thing. I just put like those little dot lights. I don't know what they're called. They're just like little spotlights or something. I don't know. They're really ugly to use on their own, but they look pretty okay whenever you like put them behind shutters or something. That's basically what I use them for. Or I'll size them all the way down, put them behind paintings or something, like canvases, you know, just to light up an area that needs it, or I don't actually want there to be an actual light that you can see. So yeah, I like using those lights. I just don't like the way they look, so I usually try to hide them behind things. But I thought it looked quite nice with the little vanity area. And then for whatever reason, whenever you put a stereo on something and you use the move objects cheat, sometimes it'll work, sometimes it won't. I don't understand why. I don't understand the logic behind it, but it's just a thing that happens. So if it doesn't work for you, you're just gonna keep trying and eventually it'll work. Or you can just, you know, go into build mode and just move it into place and it should work, you know, just fine. Whatever. And then in this one, I guess this one is kind of more like a fitnessy type person. I don't know. I put a punching bag, so it works, I guess. And then, you know, maybe they're into bowling. So yeah, I'm learning as we watch this what this sim is all about, because I completely forgot. But I did have an idea in mind for who they were at the time I was building it. I should probably write it down next time. But you know, whatever. I really like the bathroom. It's very colorful. I usually don't use the really colorful tubs and stuff, like the shower curtains. Like for this specific tub, I usually don't use the really colorful shower curtains. I'm just not a color person. If you guys have seen my other videos, you know this about me. My favorite color is white. So yeah, I try not to use color too often, just because I'm just not a fan of it. But in this apartment, I felt like it kind of needed it, especially the warmer tones. But we're onto the screenshots now. Thank God I can stop talking. But I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up, leave a comment, or subscribe. And be sure to check out everyone else's channels and Twitters, whatever. I'll have all the links in the description for you guys. But thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!